Scorpio, welcome to Sag Life Tarot. I'm a Sagittarius. I'm Shannon, and I love to read cards. And I have so many before you for our first visit, for my invitational visit, to let you know that I have quite a few. Actually, I'm kind of addicted. It's my addiction. I love to read cards. I'm Shannon. I'm 48. Wow. I will be 48 December 1st. Okay. Sagittarius, I am. Scorpio, I'm fully aware of who you are. Absolutely. Again, I'm 47. Those seven lives up there, those are my seven lives. Those are my children who are grown people now. So I'm blessed to have made it through it all. Okay. And to begin, I do have sage here. I do have crystals. I put crystals on top of everything. I won't use any of those cards today. Otherwise, you'll get a reading that'll be for hours instead of minutes. I do, however, Scorpio, like to do a prayer before I do anything. So pray with me, won't you? Divine creator, divine source, divine energy, divine radiant, vibrant, divine. Become humble and grateful. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for joining in with me. Okay, so this is my first time doing a Scorpio read, but not for a Scorpio. Just Scorpio on YouTube. I read for Sagittarius, and I'm starting to read for everybody. So let's just do a quick read, see the energy. What's the overall energy? I love to read the bottom of the deck. It's a good overall energy, and it also can sometimes give you a feeling of what's to adventure, pre-adventure behind that energy. So Scorpio, hey, thank you for tuning in. Thank you for showing it. Showing up and showing out for you, for me, for me, for me, and for you. Starting out this read with the Three of Cups. I really don't get into the signs too much because everybody end up in your read. I'm just going to tell you. Three of Cups, this is a celebration. Somebody is praying for something. Something is happening. Something is coming. Something is extremely pleasant. This is going to be amazing as well. With the way this starry is in the sky, this is going to be absolutely breathtaking. And it's time to celebrate you, maybe a situation you've been in, maybe celebrating something here. Chariot card in reverse. I do take reverses. This is a general read. Okay, so if it don't resonate with you, please don't even take it in. If it does, take it in. Take criticism, but also take in goodness and mercy here in Sag world, in my world, in Shannon's space. This is prosperity and a peaceful place to be, okay? I just want you to hear it at peace. You heard that? Peace. Okay, so this chariot in reverse could mean somebody's car has been messing up lately. I normally get the getting a new car. So here it's saying that somebody is not getting a new car. Somebody is not, whose car is not working good right now. It's been maybe problems back and forth with this vehicle here. Ace, Queen of Swords. I don't know why I say Ace. Queen of Swords. But you firm on the energy, firm on, all right, it is what it is with this vehicle. Not just that, the energy of the stability, the willpower, somebody else's energy is unstable, very, very slow, not quick to make decisions. But with the Queen of Swords, a decision is definitely made. Something is final. Queen of Swords energy here, you can reverse. It's no genders here. Let's just say that. So it could be queen, it could be a feminine energy, it can be a masculine energy. I get the Five of Cups. The way the Queen of Swords is sitting here saying that this energy is waiting for something to happen, possibly looking for something that has been gone for a while, with this Chariot card, which is Cancer energy. The Cups is Cancer as well. This is Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces with the Cups, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius with the Swords, and guess Swords, and the Chariot is Cancer. I don't get into that too often because all signs mean everything. We are all things, okay? With the Five of Cups here, this is unsatisfied, missing something, not happy with what you have, looking for something bigger here, letting go of things that don't serve a good purpose anymore, feeling abandoned even a little bit, feeling left out, feeling alone. But the star is still shining in the sky, and there is still another bowl here while she has her foot inside of the bowl, kicking over what is inside of the bowl, releasing it. But knowing that the energy is of someone who feels like there is still something to be had here. She has a bowl here with something still in it. So there is something still, to be had. Gemini energy, the Lovers popping out. Now this is strong decision, strong decisive energy. This is understanding that there is something you have to commit to. The Lovers could also mean somebody is coming with love. Bottom of the deck energy, the Sun card. I got a 6 card spread here. Wow. So somebody could be in a possible relationship, coming into a newer relationship here, or somebody's relationship is turning into an even greater relationship. With the Sun card, this energy is suggesting that everything your heart's desire is here. Whatever you were expecting, hope is restored, faith is restored, everything you're hoping for restored. Energy from nowhere, energy from everywhere. Mm-hmm. Where did it come from? You don't know. Nowhere, everywhere, right? But the energy is saying that we're going to clarify each one of these. I absolutely am. Let's see what we can get out of this, Scorpio. Okay, now we got the Three of Cups here. Let's go ahead and clarify. What is this Three of Cups? Oh, we got a Hierophant for the Three of Cups. Again, that is a marriage situation. That is a unity, a combination of a family coming together. I want y'all to know right now, I feel the energy of with these three people, with the Three of Cups and the Hierophant, this could possibly be some type of poly relationship. Don't get me wrong. Everything in life consists of everything. But with this celebrating card here and these three right here and the Hierophant being on top of it, somebody has been questioning what it is that they figure to be their own right and wrong move in life, because people told you one thing as you were growing up. You were told maybe this is not the way love is supposed to be. But with this Hierophant energy, you definitely know. Look at that Taurus popping out. Just Virgo energy here. Just Gemini energy. Everybody is here. So logic, heart space, Pentacles not even on the board, but with the Hierophant, Taurus is here. So that lets you know that this is still earthly bound energy, letting you know that it's your decision to be made. Whatever type of relationship you want to be in, summer solstice is backing up this Chariot energy that's in reverse. The summer solstice, summer is over, is it? It says in a few more weeks, this is the pinnacle of success. This is the energy you've been hoping for. It's time to have fun. Celebrate yet again with that Three of Cups energy. That is also a celebration. So in one aspect, it could be some celebration going on with the friends and family on the account of something wonderful happening. Somebody getting a ring. Somebody being, it's a possible childbirth here. Why do I feel that energy with the Sun card radiating so strong opening up the womb, yes, and releasing seeds of greatness here, right? So at this time, Scorpio, something is happening. The summer solstice, and with the Queen of Swords, the Ten of Swords, the Queen of Swords and Ten of Swords, first of all, the Queen of Swords is already a cutthroat action. So if you are letting go of something, just like that, the Queen of Swords, let it go, get rid of it. Just like that. No questions asked, Queen of Swords energy. With the Ten of Swords, it's the end of whatever that was breaking down, whatever that, not just the divorce here. Now listen, we get over here, somebody look like they getting married, and overhead look like somebody cutting off a marriage. Okay, understand this Queen of Swords energy said, time for somebody to get going, okay? And it might have been a move that made this energy feel so depressed and so sad, and knew that it was necessary, Ten of Swords. It was absolutely necessary, but at the same time, it was still a saddened energy. But having let go, look at the Lovers and the Sun card. But let's get some more energy, Scorpio. Okay, did you see how that jumped out like that? Eight of Coins is clarifying this Five of Cups. So although in the energy of not feeling too much loved, not feeling a reciprocant of love, so you good at giving it, you good at pouring it out onto people, you don't even need your hands no more, you're using your feet to pour the love out, so you good at pouring out love to people, but it's not a reciprocal thing. This is exactly why she is pouring it out. It's not coming back to her and good energy. So she getting rid of what's not good. She, he, let's go there now, because it doesn't have to be, it can be the both of the energies, or it can be the one, dominant man, female, whichever one energy. Let's resonate where we resonate, right? So with this energy, not only being, I keep saying she because I'm a she, okay, I will say he because I'm telling you I'm so dominant, but we're not going to do that today, Scorpio. We're going to read these cards, okay? We'll get into me later. Somebody has learned to master letting go with this queen of swords, and the fact that she is pouring this out, the fact that the energy is being poured out, knowing how to master that energy, knowing how to get rid of something, knowing how to bring something to you, and if it does not fit, if it does not resonate, being able to get let it go. Scorpio, it looks like real strongly here, you also, somebody else's energy is so good at whatever it is you do at work. And you've been so caught up in whatever it is you do at work, you're real committed to this, that you, love is not even on your radar. Love not even on the plans, not in the books. But King of Coins is representing the Lover's card, which yet and still at the end of this is Ace of Cups, which yet and still confirms the fact that you've been working so hard. Love has not even been at the forefront of your idea. You might have thought about it every here and there. You get the time to think about it, but not really, because you're too busy working on your stability, working on your abundance. Your self-worth is not determined by what you do, but because you so mastered and skilled and stuck to it, committed to it, believed in it, detailed in it, you are hardworking, dependable, successful, grounded, abundant, security, stable, stability, goodness, wealth, all rolled up in this. But listen, you might not have been looking for love, but I need you to know love is on its way. Yeah, here it comes. It said it's not going to leave you out here. We're going to get this love energy right here, because love is not leaving you out. Not at all. Ace of Cups is here on top of the Sun card. Well, you can't even ask for, you might be so successful, which you really, really are, King of Coins, whether it be feminine or masculine energy. Either way, hun, because I strongly stay in my masculine energy. So if I'm talking to a masculine, then you understand in the King of Coins aspect that your energy is stable, security. When somebody comes to you, pentacles is not an issue. That's not an issue with you. Okay, but this love thing might have been an issue. It might have not been no love here. It wasn't nothing pouring into you. You were pouring into others, but nothing came back to you. But with this Sun card and this Ace of Cups, oh, King of Coins. Hold fast. Masculine, feminine, King of Coins. Okay, whether you're a female or a male, whatever way you sit, sweetheart, love is coming, and I'm a prove it. Let's get this love, these love oracles out here. Ace of Cups, that's overflowing of love. That's love coming from all over the place. And it's looking like you're going to meet your twin flame. This is what it is. It's the twin flame, Scorpio. Oh, my goodness. Stabbed in the back, child. You're going to realize I say child quite often. I'm asking you when I say child to pause. Because everybody look at you like, what do you mean, child? I'm a grown person. When I say child, pause. Okay? Because this suggests then that you should look for your inner child. Because inner child is giving you the ability to deal with things in a different perspective. See, as an adult, you would deal with it by wanting to lay paws on somebody that stabs you in your back. It makes sense. Lay paws on them now because they can do something. But in child, when you get in your inner child, it gives you the ability to hold fast now. Let me find a reason to laugh at this silver lining. And then let me respond with loving kindness and forgiveness. I'm gonna have a little mercy on you as well. Okay, and let it be. Child the coffin. It came out in reverse, but I'm not playing with them like that. We ain't gotta read this card in reverse. This card say everything you need to say. You hear me? The Ten of Swords is out here. And this will be clarifying the Ten of Swords, the Queen of Swords as well. Remember that now. So that's saying that you cutting off, you not playing. There is no more games to be had. Whoever, whatever was against you or not on your behalf, you realize it's time to let that go. Not only with this coffin energy, is that a new beginning and an ending, because it got to end to begin, and it got to begin to end something, okay? So it's growth and change, liberation here. Now, our condolences, my condolences, everybody who's listening, everybody who's here, our condolences to anybody who is actually losing somebody, because it is also a transition card. That is exactly what it is. The Phoenix. This is a new phase. We just said new beginning, new phase, new love here, new romance. Listen, this is your season to open up and take in and receive, because you've been a strong, independent giver. But you have not been able to receive, Scorpio. I feel that real strongly here. Real strong. Phoenix. The new phase. Rekindling. Somebody might come back around from the past. And it's going to give you a renewal. It's growth here. And a change of mind. Okay. Knocking out King of Swords out. Oh my gosh, y'all. I say King of Swords. That's the King of Coins. The snake is here. Oh my goodness. Scorpio, who is this? Who is this? I feel real strongly like it's time to, you might have to lay your hands on somebody, because this is somebody which could just be competition, could be somebody competing with you, trying to overwin somebody. It's say the other woman, you got to be careful, the other woman or the other man. Oh, look at here. The Sun card and the Ace of Cups is clarified, but not enough. So whatever relationship it was, whoever it was, who was a snake, whoever was against you, that is not enough in your life anymore. You are not putting up with that anymore. You are ready to move on with your life. And having moved on, the Ace of Cups and the Sun card still strong in your energy. Let's get a, we got the snake out here, a phoenix out here. let's get a spirit animal and see what spirit animal the Scorpio resonate with. What is the Scorpio resonating with in spirit animal world today? What animal? Holy Spirit, holy angels, thank you. Scorpio, guess what it says? It says frog, prosperity. I wish you could see it. I know it's so far away. Listen, we're going to have a different setup when I come back next week because I'm going to do this once a week for you, Scorpio. Frog, prosperity, let go of the past and embrace change. Opportunities are close at hand. Hop into this new day with joy, abundance, and good fortune awaits you, Scorpio. Can we just reflect on the fact that we just said you got a whole lot of newness going on right now? Okay, because this Ten of Swords is a new opportunity. Why? Because when you get out of something and you break something, you end something, and it's the rock bottom, it's a new opportunity to arise and be stronger, right? So that's newfound strength as well. With this coffin, that is a new beginning, new transformation, new liberation, new growth. The Phoenix, new phase. You just got a lot of newness going on. Ace of Cups, new romance. Frog, new day. Okay, you know we all got a new day. I'm gonna put some money out here. Scorpio, we gonna put some money on this board because I can't leave you without no money. I gave you some love, love oracles. That was the love oracles. I will tell you every deck I used. I'm mad because I did. But the decks I used was the Light Seers. The Light Seers and Intuit Tarot and the Lovers. And that was the spirit animals. This is the money deck. Patience. Have patience. Whatever you waiting for, whatever you working on, the hard work you put in is paying off. Media. Somebody is in the media. Somebody is being recognized on TV. Somebody is doing radio. Okay, you got a lot of cards. Motivator. Somebody is unfulfilled. We said that, not enough. Prudence. Be careful with your money. Put some money away for a rainy day. Somebody is the teacher. Let's get some more out here. Holy Spirit, holy angels. Destiny. It's a part of your destiny. You have to go through. You have to stay going. You have to stay strong. Somebody is an artist, or somebody is starting art school. Somebody is starting an art business. A partnership is being formed here. A partnership is starting. Somebody is a new partner. Put the mistakes that happened behind you. Forgive yourself and move on. This is supposed to be the most comfortable time of your life. Comfort here. Next level. You are moving up to the next level. This, I'm going to put some fortune cookies out here for you because I seen fortune was out here, and I love all my decks, y'all. But this is one of my favorites, one of them, because I have 30-something and all 30 of them are my favorite. Major life changes. Time is right for major life changes as a new lifestyle or location brings great joy and a trouble-free existence. I'm going to get one more. Come on. Society, say yes to all the wonderful invitations coming your way. Excellent networking opportunities and new love interests for singles will be the result. There you have it. Again, Scorpio, new love is coming. You might not have been looking for it, but it's definitely coming for you. That was fortune cookies. This is mindful messages. I do get a whole lot of other cards. I'm just going to be using different decks for every different read I do. And I'm going to do a read once a week for you, Scorpio. Once a week. So, just like it. Just be there. Come on, Holy Spirit, Holy Angels. Give us a mindful message. Let's just grab one off the top. Personal journey. I follow what feels right within me without needing validation from others. We are each on our own journey, and mine does not need to look like anyone else's. My enjoyment and satisfaction is validation enough. Scorpio, thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for being here for me. And I absolutely love you. And I will see you soon. Enjoy the rest of this night.